Yo, what's up, Biggie Astrology with the Astro Weather? Friday, Viernes, Venus, Secret Saturday. Forget about a Friday. April 12th, April 13th, April 14th, Secret Saturday, Sabado, Saturn, Coffee Talk, 12 noon Eastern. Be there. Sign up today. BiggieAstrology@gmail.com. You can pay Cash App, Zelle, PayPal. And Sunday, Domingo, the Sun. All right. So, yeah, we're looking at all 3 days at Astro-Weather Weekend. Hope you're doing well. Hope you've integrated this new solar energy. How you been feeling? I've been really energized and then really loopy and tired and not exhausted, tired and a little dizzy in a fog. Still that Mars-Saturn conjunction. Mars is pulling away. The moon's in Gemini today and a bit tomorrow. And we're going to have a Gemini-Cancer weekend in the Astro-Weather. So let's get to the chart. Let's not waste time recording a podcast today and another one next week. So they'll air in the future. I'll let you know. You check my playlist, interviews and media. Aries birth chart sale, sun, moon, rising, 100-208. And Astrological Coffee Talk with Eric tomorrow, Saturday, April 13th, 12 p.m. Eastern, 2 hours over Zoom, $20 or 9 a.m. Pacific. And we're going to look at the COVID-19 pandemic shutdown chart, March 15, 2020. Oh, what a time. We've been through a lot in the last 4 years. Let's investigate that shutdown chart. What was really going on? The chart will speak to us. All right. Then in the second hour, we're going to read a birth chart together, reveal who it is at the end, see how we did of our interpretation and analysis. So just email me, BigEAstrology@gmail.com. Any other services, signing up for the newsletter, go to BigEAstrology.com and book it, Dano. All right. Gemini moon. Talkie. I have a sun with this moon, so I know a lot about it. All right. Let's get to the astro weather. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 12th, 13th, 14th of April. April, my cousin's birthday Sunday. Had a bunch of friends with birthday yesterday. Happy birthday, Aries. Look that birth chart sale. You won't regret it. Astro weather. Pew. All right, we're not looking at a particular ascendant, but this is 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific. The moon in Gemini, 16 degrees, the bee's knees for she's. Well, it's going to finish up at around 22 East Coast, 23 West Coast. Okay, so then tomorrow around 12 noon, around Coffee Talk, the moon should be, and maybe a little bit before, entering into Cancer for half a Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. All right, so that's the moon. And it's good to track the moon. Book my moon tracking service, $134. Learn about the moon in each sign in each house. And this moon, coming off the square to Mars and Saturn in Pisces, and then it will get closer and closer, and really on Sunday morning, it will square Neptune. So, you know, there could be some communication about, compassion, empathy, you know, disagreements about, you know, military, stuff like that, things about spirituality, misinterpreting dreams. You know, Gemini Pisces squares can be kind of interesting. There's definitely a lot of mutable energy of back and forth. So just sometimes you got to agree to disagree and walk away. But there could be opportunities to learn, see new perspectives. Jupiter, look at that, closer, 20. Well, it's almost at 20 and it's in the conjunction, but remember April 21st. So we're getting closer and closer, start of Taurus season, Taurus birth chart sale, and my mom's birthday and the Jupiter Uranus conjunction in Taurus. And she was a Taurus. So you see the sun is passed by Mercury. You know, we're in that final decan, the Aries Sagittarius decan. And this moon, you know, late tonight will kind of sextile. It's going to sextile Mercury and the sun. You know, maybe could make you emotionally want to communicate and problem solve, figure things out a little quicker. With Mercury retrograde, which is the ruler of this Gemini moon, we gotta slow down. Not so impulsive on Friday. Not so, you know, watch out for the accidents, the car ride home, all that stuff. But just slow down, right? And remember, we got this Lilith back in Virgo. Did a little dance in Libra, and it's back in Virgo with Juno, sort of opposing
You know, close to in between the, opposing the Mars and the Neptune. Okay. You can feel that, you know, maybe 5 degree orb. Still got the South Node rocking at 15 degrees in Libra, Aries North Node, Chiron. Don't forget, we still have got to walk into this new energy, a new beginning of being brave and courageous, independent leaders of our own lives and healing that childhood wound about taking charge, about initiating, about, you know, taking action and asserting yourself properly. Those can be challenges sometimes. Okay. Didn't check the news. Hopefully Mars, Saturn stuff, nothing really played out so wild or so crazy. I'm kind of tired of listening to the news. So, you know, I might not give you so much mundane astrology. You know, and then obviously we have an RIP for Ornithole James Simpson, Hall of Fame running back, and notorious for being accused of killing Ron Goldman and Nicole Brown Simpson. Who knows? Could it have been him? Could it have been Colombian Necktie Mafia? Could have been AC Collins? Could have been his son Jason? Could he have had help? Who knows? RIP OJ. 2,000 yards, 14 games. Impressive. Not the nicest person in the world, and definitely abusive, domestic violence, and narcissist. So I have no respect for any man that ever hits a woman. And DJ Mr. C, the DJ from Hot 97, a Big Daddy Kane, did some music with Biggie. Yeah, DJ Mr. C, 56. I think OJ was 76, so yeah. And I don't know, there's rumors that King Charles is losing his battle. We'll see. You know, things happen after eclipses a lot of time with leaders. But let's get to Saturday, April 13th, Coffee Talk. And we're going to look at 9 a.m. Pacific, 12 noon Eastern. That's when Coffee Talk starts. All right. Email me, BigEAstrology@gmail.com. Book your spot at Coffee Talk today. People signing up. All right. Astro Weather, Friday. Forget about it, Friday. Venus. Pew. All right. We're not looking at a particular ascendant, but it's 12 noon Eastern. And look at that, I told you, Jupiter is at 20 degrees here on the 13th, just a week away, right? Basically, Sunday would be a week away from the 21st. So, and that Gemini moon, ooh, like I said, it'd be close, but it's almost there, 29 degrees. So it's basically going to move into Cancer closer to 1 p.m. Eastern. And so, like I said, we'll have it all, you know, half a Saturday, all Sunday and Monday. Okay, so that Gemini moon will be wrapping up, but it'll be squaring Neptune. So, you know, there could be some communication. There could be some confusion. There could be some disagreements about the COVID-19 chart, you know, but really it's just about like, maybe there's curiosity and things to interpret and see where was there deceptions in the pharmaceuticals, right? Stuff like that, you know, different things that were changed and, you know, whatever. I can't talk too much about it here on YouTube, but, you know, just tough time, real tough time for everybody. But the Aries sun is moving along, right? Happy birthday, all the Aries. Remember the 20th, the sale ends. It's just a week away, okay? So, you know, we're really going to get into Taurus season, I think, on the 20th, not the 21st this year because of, because of a leap year. So things can shift, right? So if your solar return is April 13th, you may need to actually look at it on the 12th this year in terms of the actual degree point. That's how you set up the solar return chart, just so you know. Okay, so Venus is still moving along in Aries, and it's actually moving kind of quick. And you see Mars is going to get closer and closer to Neptune. That Mars-Neptune conjunction could be really, really interesting. And the Gemini moon will be also opposing the galactic center in Sagittarius. All right, and you see the galactic center over there, 27 degrees. So, you know, maybe you have some communications with some Arcturians or some Lyrans or, you know, somebody, and or maybe you start to really understand and through your meditation or in the Akashic records, tap in to your starseed lineage. All right. You know, we're here for a reason, you guys. Lilith is still in its place, kind of squaring, you know, coming off the square to the moon. And we're still dealing with the nodes at 15 degrees. You know, we have to find, you know, Saturday opportunities to ground in nature. You know, that Capricorn's kind of trying in the Lilith and Ceres, the goddess of harvest. Tap into the garden, hug a tree, get the vibrations and frequencies. Hugging a tree, you can get similar energies and frequencies as if you are putting your feet or palms in the ground and earth, right? Because the tree is rooted in the earth. Everything is vibration and frequency, and they're conscious living organisms. Okay, so Jupiter, Uranus, and Taurus, this is definitely a great time to tap into that. You know, Aries season, hey, we got to take advantage of it. The North Node, Chiron. And as Venus gets closer to Chiron, you're going to definitely, in the North Node, you're going to definitely feel, you know, going for the rays and then at the same time healing old relationships, healing relationships with childhood friends, or healing the relationship and increasing things with your self-love, but also how you initiate and assert yourself, where maybe you're like, I don't want to be in the matrix anymore in the 9-to-5 programming. I'm going to be a leader and I want to start my own job and career, my own path. You know, Venus North Node, Venus Chiron conjunctions can definitely inspire and lead to those things. And, you know, just watch out with the Mars and Pisces, the escapism, the duality, and not being empathetic and compassionate, being too assertive and aggressive, all right? So let's get to sleep on a Sunday. Strawberry fish forever. At Gemini moon, I'd say it loves to communicate. All right, Astro weather for Sabado, seek it Saturday. Pew. Ay, Domingo, sleep on it, Sunday, baby, ba, 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 the Cancer moon is dancing, baby, bailando. Well, you know, the Cancer moon is definitely about safety, security, can be moody, super sensitive. It's all up in its feelings, but it has that deep sage wisdom, right? Cancer's at home there. Its true home is in Taurus, where it's exalted. But, you know, this is really feeling things sometimes in the stomach and the chest and breast. You know, it can be overprotective. It's, you know, slow to trust, but it's about safety, security. Cancer moons can be very funny. It's very sweet and mushy. All right. Great people, great energy. But so it's at 12 degrees, 12 noon Eastern on Sunday. We'll finish up at about 18, 19 on the West Coast. So you're still going to, you know, have it all day Monday. Okay. And then we'll start Tuesday early with the Leo moon, Tuesday, Wednesday, un poquito Thursday, right? And we'll have a Virgo moon weekend next weekend with a little bit of Libra. You see how this works? 60 hours, 2.5 days. I'm born to a maze, going through the craze. I spit ill bars in astrological ways. Part of fortune is here with Juno and Virgo, but that's just for this ascendant at 12 noon Eastern. But that Lilith, still there, still dancing, you know, kind of going back and forth. And you're going to see the nodes start to shift soon. They're getting closer and closer to 14. And, you know, that Jupiter-Uranus conjunction will be exact on the 21st. So a week away. All right. And so that degree in 1 week, you know, you'll feel that energy. Now this Aries sun at 25 degrees. So you're talking on the 14th. Right, so 4 more days to 29 degrees, okay, from the 14th, right, that's the 18th, then the 0 degree, the 19th, so really we're probably going to enter Taurus season around the 19th or 20th, late night, okay, so just get ready for that. But I'm still going to start. Maybe I'll start the Aries, the Taurus birth chart sale on the 21st, just the same day when the Aries birth chart sale ends. But I think overall for Sunday, there's definitely an energy of grounding. The Cancer moon is going to trine the Saturn. And so that can show you that through your spiritual gifts and your even spiritual and emotional discipline, you can really get some, even some downloads of revelation about your lineage, your family, things about your home, new insights on, oh, you know, I need to build this or repair this in the home. You know, it can even help you. This is a good time on Sunday to really even start a dream book. I do that with a lot of my clients. If you've never done that, and you could always email me, give you insights on that at BigEAstrology@gmail.com. But Sunday is definitely, you know, there could be some emotions coming up. And that remember that Cancer moon is going to square. It's coming off of the square on Saturday to Venus, but it's going to square the North Node and Chiron and Aries. So there could be some sensitivities and emotions about not being brave and courageous, or even in some ways, maybe how you dealt with maybe people holding you back in childhood or holding yourself back, you know, limiting beliefs, or sometimes, you know, being a little fearful, not willing to initiate. Well, the Cancer moon is going to kind of like reflect on that, you know, may even think about like, well, oh, well, you know, my mom didn't say this, my dad didn't tell me that. But at some point, we've got to kind of, right, be responsible for ourselves. All right. So that's an opportunity to heal some of those wounds, those squares, opportunities for growth, right? We can gain major insight and look within. Cancer moon, cardinal, water sign, feminine energy. It's going to be introspective. All right. So Sunday could be a good time, dream book, journaling, healing childhood wounds, forgiving mom and dad, all that good stuff all up in the world. And look at Pluto doing its thing, moving to the second degree. So, okay, you'll feel a different vibration with Pluto in Aquarius. That's as high as it's going to go, because it is, I don't think it gets to the third degree before it retrogrades back September 1st into Capricorn. Actually, I'm probably, yeah, it doesn't. So, you know, see the difference, see how you feel. It doesn't change with the lunar mansion behind it, but just even with the degree, it does change in that Aquarius deacon going from 1 to 2 degree. All right, so just, you know, see how you feel, just pay attention to it, especially when the moon and other different planets start to really aspect it. You may notice it when that moon goes from Cancer to Leo, okay, and it's opposing it on Tuesday morning or whatever early. You may feel some things. So that's the astro weather. Enjoy. Have a good astrological weekend. Gemini, Cancer, Moon, communicate. And just let go of some hurt emotions and feelings. Trust your intuition. You know what you know. Believe that you know it. All right? God bless. Biggie Astrology. Astro Weather Weekend. Pew, pew, pew. Peace. Alright, that's it. Astro Weather Weekend. It's Friday, baby. Hit me up. Sign up for Astrological Coffee Talk with Eric, which is tomorrow, Saturday, April 13th, 13, at 12 noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. 2 hours, $20. We're looking at the COVID-19 pandemic shutdown chart, and then we're going to look at a perf chart, reveal it, read it, and then it gets revealed. Instant feedback, interpretation, and analysis. No paralysis. Aries birth chart sale, both of them. Hit me up, or and also Lilith Chiron, BigEAstrology@gmail.com. All right? And yeah, I got to go. I got to get ready for my podcast interview. Enjoy. I'll see my clients next week. This was a great week with clients. And just thank you. Thank you for supporting. And hopefully you watch and go back and watch Miss Vivienne Chauvet from episode 199. Wednesday night, it was powerful, talking about Arcturians, talking about the fifth dimension and our soul and the energy and just how we're vibrating and vibrating from love. She did a really great grounding DNA activation. It was powerful. Go watch that episode and We'll be announcing the giveaways over the weekend. We're doing a Sabale Pure and Biggie Astrology giveaway for episode 200. A thank you to the audience. We'll be on Monday night, 8:30 p.m. Eastern, 5:30 p.m. Pacific, okay, on YouTube. And it's going to be a lot of fun. So come join us and have a good time for episode 200, where I am in gratitude and thanking you guys. And I'll be talking about Aries in Jupiter and Aries in Saturn. The great benefic in Jupiter, the great malefic in Saturn. But also just celebrating all you guys who support me. And we will pick, probably live on air, some winners. You're going to have to, you know, subscribe and follow Biggie Astrology on YouTube and Instagram. And if you have it, X. And Sabale Pure on YouTube and Instagram. But we'll put everything up in community, so check it out. All right, so I'll see you for episode 200. Can't believe I'm there on Monday. I guess it'll be Cancer Moon finishing up. All right. Eric Taylor, Astro Weather Weekend, April. You know what it is. 12th, 13th, 14th, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Biggie Astrology. Have a good one. I hope I see your coffee talk. Email me, Cash App, PayPal, Cash App, $T2UC, PayPal, tailoredtoyoucoaching@gmail.com. Pay as a friend. Zelle, hit me up. Just email me, BigEAstrology@gmail.com. Adios. Peace.